This is Ed Delgado, the National Predictive Services Program Manager in Boise, Idaho. We just released the summer outlook for June, July, August, and September, and we have some conditions that have kept the fire season at bay through the month of May, as that was rather cool and a little bit wet. But we're starting to transition into the heat of summer, and conditions will start to change pretty rapidly. Across most of the West, we have an abundance of grass fuels and fine shrub fuels that will contribute to a lot of fire this summer across parts of Arizona, New Mexico, and southern Nevada. As we transition into the warmer parts of the year, more into July, we'll start to see the fire season spread farther north into the northern parts of the Great Basin, southern Idaho, and into parts of central and southern California. Concerns in Southern California this year are coming out of a very strong long-term drought. A couple of conditions are in place for increasing fire activity across the state. One is a lot of fine fuels in the lower and mid elevations that will contribute to fire spread, rapid fire spread in the right conditions, but also a lot of the stress over the last several years in the timber country has left a lot of tree mortality in the higher elevations of California, and that will also potentially contribute to some pretty large fire activity. As we move into the later months of August and September, we'll start to see fire season wind down in parts of the Southwest as the monsoon is in full force, but we'll continue to see fire activity moving north in the northern parts of the Great Basin and continuing in parts of California, particularly the mountain and foothills areas. Areas that are not highlighted as above normal in this outlook doesn't mean those areas won't have a lot of fire. Normal fire conditions during the summer in those areas still means a lot of fire on the landscape. So keep that in mind as the season progresses and the forecast starts to transition with new information.